Hi everybody, it's Teacher John, and today we're going to do a little science experiment. Today we're going to be talking about germs. Do you know what germs are? What are germs? If you don't know, that's okay. But if you do know, you probably know that germs are tiny little things that you cannot see. And they live on your hands, maybe on your couch, on your cell phone. They live all over the world. And that's okay. Many germs are okay, but some germs will make you... some germs make you sick. I am not really sick, don't worry. So, germs are these really tiny, small things that you can't see. And we need to make sure that we get rid of germs so we don't get sick. Does anybody know what one way to get rid of germs is? What is a good way to get rid of germs? Very good, you can wash your hands. Washing your hands is very important to do before you eat or brush your teeth and after you go to the bathroom. Because if you wash your hands, all the germs will go away and you will be able to eat food and touch your face and it will be okay. So make sure you wash your hands a lot. And when we wash our hands, I know we need water. What is one more thing we need when we wash our hands? Water and, good job, soap. We need water and soap to wash our hands, and that will make the germs go away. But why does that make the germs go away? I have an idea. Maybe the germs are scared of soap, and they run away. What do you think? Do you think that germs are scared of soap? Yes or no? All right, do you have an answer? Do you think germs are scared of soap? If your teacher gave you this paper and wants you to write down your answer, please write down your answer. Are germs scared of soap? Why do you think so? Make sure you write why. If your teacher did not give you the paper, don't worry. So, for this science experiment, you will need one plate or bowl, some water, some pepper, or anything else that is very small and has a color and will float in water, and some dish soap that you will use to wash your dishes. So go get a plate or bowl, water, pepper, or something else like pepper, and dish soap. Ready, set, go! You can stop the video and hit play when you are ready. All right, do you have your water, your pepper, your soap, and your plate or bowl? Awesome, here we go. The first thing that you have to do is pour some water into your plate or into your bowl. Be careful that you don't spill and make a big mess. The next thing that we will do is open your pepper. I know pepper is not really a germ, but today we will pretend that this is a germ, okay? All these little pieces of pepper are tiny germs, okay? Pretend they are germs. Pour them into your water like this, and you will see that they are all floating on top of your water, just like the little germs are all on your hand, but you can't see them. What we are going to do is you will take your dish soap, put a little bit on your finger like this, and then you will touch the middle, right in the middle of your plate or your bowl, okay? So put some soap on your finger and you will touch the middle. Before you do it, I want you to think in your head, what will happen when I put soap on my finger and touch in the middle of the water? What will happen to all the germs? What do you think? Pause the video until you have an answer. Do you know what will happen? Will the germs all jump to the camera? Will they all start to dance? Will the germs turn into a giant, beautiful rainbow? I don't know. Let's find out. So, You can go ahead and stop the video and do it by yourself, or you can watch me do it first. All right, here we go. I have my dish soap, and I'm gonna put just a little bit on my finger. Make sure you don't do this right on top of the plate, because then if you spill, it will mess up the science. All right, so I'm ready to put my finger with the soap into the middle of the plate. And it's very fast, so make sure you watch what happens. 3, 2, 1, go. Whoa, did you see that? What happened? Yeah, very good. All the germs ran away from the soap on my finger. Nice, that was pretty cool. So make sure that you do the science experiment right now on your own. Hit pause and then play the video when you are all done. The next question I have for you, once you finish doing it, is what happens when you put soap on your finger and put it in the water? What happens? If your teacher gave you this paper, you can write your answer here. 1 or 2 sentences. What happened when you put the soap on your finger and put it into the water with the germs? And if it did not work for you, you can just do it one more time. So pause the video and answer the question. What happened when you put soap on your finger and put your finger in the water? Hit play when you are done. Okay, I just cleaned up my plate or my bowl, and I thought that was so fun, I want to try it one more time. But this time, I will change one thing. I will make one thing different, because that is very important in science, to change something and see what happens. Some things that you can change are how much pepper do you put in? How much water do you put in? How much soap do you put in? You can change if the water is hot or cold. There are so many things you can change. You could put it in a really big bowl, in a really tall cup. So, I want you to think of one thing that you will change, okay? What do you want to change? Pause the video and hit play when you are ready to go. Do you know what you want to change? Well, if you want to change 2 or 3 things, that's okay, but just pick one for right now. After you do it this time, you can do it again and again, but only change one thing every time. So, I'm going to put in the same amount of pepper, just like I did last time. And what I'm going to change is I'm going to put in a lot of soap, okay? And because I'm putting in a lot of soap, I'm not gonna put it on my finger. I'm just gonna go like this. Are you ready to see what happens? All right, 3, 2, be careful, it might be very fast. 3, 2, 1, go. Whoa, was it any different than the first time? I think when I put more soap in, it went a little bit faster. Do you think so too? So right now, I want you to pause the video and change one thing and do it by yourself. When you are all done, if you have this paper, write down the one thing you changed for question 3 and what happened when you changed it. Hit play when you are done. All right, awesome job. Did you have fun with this science experiment? I hope you did, because I really did. The last question I have for you is, why do you think this happens? I know the pepper is not, they're not really germs. So why do you think when I put the soap in the middle, all the pepper flies away? If you don't know, that's okay. Just take a guess. I will not tell you the answer right now, but maybe we will talk about it later, okay? Awesome job. Make sure you write down why you think it happens and give me a high five. Good job. The last thing you have to do before you finish is please clean up the big mess that you made so your mom and dad don't have to, okay? Clean up, have fun, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.